Hey folks, Ben from Stones here today showing you how to set up and pack away the Darche HighRize Ridgeback rooftop tents.
Hit it!
These HighRize tents have got a twin fold design to make it really easy to set up enough space to store your bedding inside and have a removable awning. Before we dive in, we've got loads more content like this on our channel, so make sure you like and subscribe below. Now let's jump into the product. In front of me here is the Darche Ridgeback HighRize rooftop tent in the 1250 version. So this measures 225 centimeters in length. Probably need to allow a little bit of an extra for the brackets on the end there, about 230 centimeters maybe. And this is 130 centimeters in width, but I'll allow a little bit more for the gas struts, so maybe about 135. If you were to get the 1550 version, it's about 160 centimeters in width, plus a bit for those the struts on the side as well, and that's the same length. Now regarding weight, the 1250 weighs 99 kilos, the 1550, 109 kilos, and then you've got your ladder at about 2 kilos plus the extra fittings and things on top of that. So they're not a lightweight tent. Make sure you check your roof rack system's load rating and your vehicle's roof load rating before you put this on top of your car, because there's a lot of cars that are going to be too small and just not rated to take a tent of this weight. Now, before we set the actual tent up, I just want to show you what comes with the kit when you buy it and how you can mount it to your roof. So you get an instruction manual, have a good read of that. You get all of this when you buy the tent. So you even get a spanner here to help you do it up. And these are all the fittings you need to attach it to your roof rack. Now, the rails that you attach it with are attached to the rooftop tent when you buy it. So these run the full length of the tent, so about 225 centimeters in length, and about 80 centimeter centers to each of these here. There's a rubber cap that goes on the end. I'll just take that one off to show you how I've sort of set this or put one together here already. But the roof rails will run perpendicular to these. So your roof rails will run underneath here, and you can then use this to attach it. So these have got these little sort of washers or inserts, I suppose, that go into the rails that sit underneath the tent here. Now, I can't push this all the way in because we've got this on top of pallets. If you can imagine this being inserted all the way into that rail there, that then creates this space for our roof rails, our roof racks, to sit in here. You can then tighten this up over the roof rack. So you'll have four mounting points for the rooftop tent. If you've got extra bars, you could mount for extra mounting points, but you probably want to make sure they're also evenly divided across the length of the tent. You don't want them too close in the middle or too far apart, so that the tent doesn't either rock or sag too much. Try and divide it up into thirds. Now, in terms of setting the actual tent up, we do that at both ends, but we start at this end here. So this end is such that the awning inside the tent that you'll see shortly comes out this way. Darche don't specifically, so I haven't found anywhere for them to say that that's the correct orientation, but all the images show that this is the front of the tent. There's no real difference otherwise, because there's entrances on all sides, so you could mount it the other way, I suppose. So to open up this side of the tent, we've got these two lock latches here. Now, these are adjustable, so they're over center latches, and you can actually lock it as well if you like. So you can put a padlock through here. So we undo these, both sides here, the red latch there, and that releases this whole top section here. From here, we just gently give this a push. Now, the gas struts hold this closed at this point here, which is really handy for pack up, which we'll show you shortly. But at some point, they take over and it just goes up by itself. You've got this strap here, which you need for pack up. We don't need that right now, so I'm just gonna throw that over the top there. And you've got this elastic strap here, which is all for pack up to pull all the fabric in. We just pull that down and tuck it into the rails or any notches down here around the base, so that that's out the way while we're using the tent. Now, at this point, and I've got them just inside here, we grab these bars here, which are the stays for the awning. Now, I'm only going to be able to put three in here today at the moment, because we've got this against the wall, so I can't put the fourth one in. And these help hold this awning out. Now, we can actually remove this awning if we want. There is a zipper around the top there, so you can actually just take that off if you don't want to use it and leave it out. But it's actually really easy to set up. We grab these. These are flexible steel poles, and they insert into these brackets here. So I push this in here through the bracket and into the actual whole base plate on the bottom there. And then I flex this upwards towards the awning. So this loop points downwards. I find the eyelet in the awning there, and I just hook that in place. And that just holds that out rigid like that. I also do it on the other side here, which will pull this out over the entrance here. And then I've got one more down the side here. So we've got protection over the three doorways at this end of the tent. So that's the HighRize half setup, I suppose. Now we could use it like this, just sloped like this. It's a bit like their traditional Ridgeback rooftop tent. Doesn't have that extra headspace. If you don't want to go down the path of setting it all up, you can certainly use it that way. So before I show you the second bit, which is actually really easy to set up, and it really isn't much extra effort to set that up anyway, but before I do that, I'll show you the ladder. Now the ladders, it comes with two lots of mounts. So there's a mount here, there's also a mount on the end of the tent, and you can move these around. So you can put these next to any door that you like, and there's doors on both sides and at each end. The ladder doesn't pack up inside the tent, the ladder goes in the back of your vehicle. It's just got these hooks here that attach onto the side of the tent like this. Now this will ideally sit at a 70 degree angle, and to adjust it, it goes out to 2.3 meters. You should extend this all the way out. So each of these all the way out. So if we can just imagine that that's extended right to the bottom there, the whole ladder is extended out. And then if we need to angle it in more, we do it from the top down. So we push this up and then the next one up like this. So we're adjusting the top sections first. So if you need to shorten the ladder, shorten it from the top, not the bottom. That way you've got this step at the bottom, nice and easy to use. Now, we set up the second part of the tent here now. To do that, we come around to the rear of the tent. We've got two more over center latches here that we can undo to set up this end of the tent. When we undo them, the tent will just sit flat because the gas struts are designed to hold it closed like that. We grab these handles and just lift them gently, and at some point the struts will take over and the tent will then pop into place. We're just about done. We set up easy as that. We'll throw this strap up over the top to keep it out of the way. That's for setup. We've got another elastic strap here that we'll just pull up and tuck into these channels on the top here. And that is how to set up the Darche Ridgeback HighRize rooftop tent. Super easy. Release one end, release the other end, and the awning, and you're all good to go. The only extra setup you'd have to do is plug a USB or power bank into the lights inside and throw your bedding in. Now I do have some bedding inside here. I'll show you in a second what I've got in there. You can pack bedding up in here. We'll demonstrate a bit more in the other door at the other end when we get to that. But we'll start to pack it up again now to show you the opposite. So pack up is just as easy as set up. Firstly, don't forget to pull these down. This is probably the most important thing really, because this is going to pull the fabric in, because the most annoying thing about setting it up, and it really isn't that annoying, is that you've got to tackle this fabric inside here. So if this was on top of a rooftop tent and we couldn't reach these handles, we've got this strap here to pull it down. But I can reach these handles, so I'm just going to push it down, and they're quite firm struts, so you do need to use a little bit of muscle to get it down. At some point it will just sit there, it won't actually want to come back up again. So we don't latch it just yet. We want to go around and make sure that it's actually all tucked in here at the moment, that all of this fabric is tucked inside the outer of the shell here. This is going to be easy if you make sure you leave doors and windows open, at least the mesh closed, but the canvas open, so that as you close this down, the air can escape out of the tent. So just check both sides. Make sure the fabric is tucked in. If you've got a second person doing this, make sure one person isn't pushing this down while the other fingers are tucked inside. Bit of fabric tucked out here. Just push that inside. Grab the strap and just tuck that inside as well. And you can just lift this slightly to get this inside there without it wanting to extend out. And we're good to close that down now. Now these latches have got, there's a bit of a bend to this sort of hook here. If you put it on this way, it doesn't seem to want to do up. Or we can't do up because it hits the actual bracket here. So make sure that these angle out this way so that when you do it up, they lock nice and firmly. So lock both of those in place. We can then go around to the other end and take the awning. So as we work our way around, we can just pull the poles out as we go. This can just stay hanging. If you have left it attached, you don't need to remove it for pack up. We'll take these poles out. We can put them back in the carry bag. And these can just be thrown inside the tent. They don't need to go separate because they're so flat, they will lay flat on top of the bedding. Now, I'll show you now inside here what I've got packed up in here. So these are the doors. I will zip this up just to keep it from flapping in the way when I pack it up, but I can leave these panels sitting loose down here because they're going to be contained inside the tent. I'll throw my poles on top of the bedding. You can see I've got a Darche, a nice thick Darche cold mountain sleeping bag in here. So this is a really warm double sleeping bag, and it's gonna pack up really easily with that inside. You probably could fit pillows in there, not really bulky pillows. We'll sort of have a look when I've packed it up what sort of space you've got inside, but you can definitely leave a double sleeping bag inside there. Next step, an important one. Well, let's zip this up first, just so that this fabric doesn't get caught up. We're not having to tuck that away. At least zip it so that it's hanging up here, so that when it folds up, it's not all hanging at the side. Grab the elastic strap here again, and put that right over the top of the awning so that it contains all the fabric inside the elastic strap. Doing this is gonna make it easy as you fold this down. This elastic pulls all this fabric into the center of the tent. Once again, windows are open so that all the air can escape. You don't get that ballooning fabric. If this was on top of a car, once again, use these straps so that you can pull it down from a height. I can actually reach these handles here at the moment, so I can pull this down. I'm gonna close it down, and just as I go, before I go too far, I'm just gonna start to pull this fabric in on the side here. If you can kind of do it from the end. If you pull from the end, you can almost get the entire length of the fabric pulled in within the boundaries of the tent there. Do that on both sides. If you can, grab a second person. I can see one point just down here that I need to just reach down to tuck it inside. There's like a rubber seal around here. Just tuck it inside that rubber seal. Then come back to the end of the tent here. Make sure all this is tucked inside. Grab your strap, bunch it up, just tuck that in there as well. You can see these struts are just holding this in a pretty comfortable or handy sort of location there. Close this down. One last check around the edge to make sure fabric hasn't come out again. And we can see that just as we close this down a bit further, that fabric's protruded out a little bit more. One last tuck in around the edges there. Checking both sides, we're good to go. Do up the over center latches. Now these are just straight, these ones here, so you might need to put a little bit of weight on top just to get that in place. Lock that down. That did up really easily there. Certainly no stress or strain trying to get this done up here. And that's all done up. You can put locks on there if you like to lock that in place so that everything inside's secure. No one can open it up. And if we have a look at perhaps where or how much space you've got inside here, the actual mattress came up to around about here. So you've got about this much space to store bedding inside. So easily fit a your sleeping bag inside, and reasonably compressible pillows you'd fit inside there as well. So you can certainly fit a good amount of warm bedding for two people. Now that is probably one of the most comfortable and luxurious rooftop tents I've seen, and probably also one of the easiest to set up. The Darche Ridgeback HighRize rooftop tents. There's two sizes, the 1250 or the 1550, if you want a bit of extra space for two people. If you've got any questions on these tents, please let us know down in the comments below. Otherwise, you can check them out online at snowways.com.au, where you find them at our lowest prices every day.